Hi, I'm Aaron, an engineer on the Steam team. Today, I'm here to talk to you about depots and packs, how you can set up your games so that players can download and update it quickly. Let's get started. These days, games can get quite big. Some are in the 100 gigabyte plus range. Games are updating quite frequently. This puts a burden on players who have to wait every time their game needs to update. What are some ways that you can make updates fast for your customers? One way is through depots. Depots are about segmenting your build so that it only has the parts that needs to be delivered to a particular customer. For the most part, this is pretty straightforward. It's similar to how it works on other platforms. You split it by language, by platform, architecture, or by DLC. Users won't have to download all languages, for example, or use the disk space. Where it gets more interesting is how you organize files within a depot. This can have a dramatic effect on players when your game is updated. Before we go deeper into this, let's take a quick diversion to talk about pack files. They go by many names, but I'm going to use the generic term pack file for batches of content stored in a single file. Most games, during development, store their game content across a gazillion loose files. When it gets closer to ship, there's some sort of cooking or baking process that combines the small files into a smaller number of large files. This generally helps the game's load time performance. For the most part, the same idea is great on Steam. But there are a couple additional considerations: download size and patch application time. It would be a huge waste of time and bandwidth if you had to fully re-download the whole game every time an update was available. Thankfully, most updates don't actually require that, or at least they shouldn't. To solve this, Steam has a built-in system that attempts to only download what's changed from prior builds, reusing parts that are the same. We call this delta patching. I'm going to now take you on a deep dive into some technical details on how this actually works under the hood. We do delta patching on a per-file basis. Here we are starting with an initial file within a depot that we're going to want to patch later. This file gets split into chunks across 1 megabyte boundaries, and we build a registry of all the hashes of those chunks. Later on, when a branch gets updated and a player's Steam client goes to download the new build, we start the process of downloading and applying patches to the original file. The first thing we do is reserve a place on disk for the updated version of the file. We then utilize a sliding window to look for 1 megabyte chunks in the registry. These are blocks that haven't changed as compared to the original file. We already have these locally, and we don't need to re-download them. Any chunks that we find are copied from the original file into the new location. Then, new chunks are downloaded to the client and put in the right place in the final. Finally, the initial file is deleted, and the new file is moved into the final location. As you may have noticed, during the update process, we have both the old and the new content at the same time. We don't have a copy of your whole game, but we do have a copy of each file that's different from the default branch. One of the reasons for this duplication is that if interrupted, the original is still available. This is especially great on Steam Deck, where connectivity can be intermittent. If you leave the house while a game is being patched, instead of being dead in the water, you can still play the version of the game that you had prior to the update. However, this does have some implications. If a game is made up of a single 30 gigabyte pack file, for example, then when your game updates, it takes an additional 30 gigabytes, even if only one byte changed. This is not great if you want the game to run on a wide variety of machines. Another implication is that even if a download is tiny, you still have to wait for the patch to be applied. Continuing with that 30 gigabyte file example, Steam only has to download one chunk, but it has to make a whole copy of the 30 gigabyte pack, which can take a while. This is often overlooked and can have a significant impact on users who just got an update and want to play it immediately. Steam allows you to organize your game within a depot any way you want. However, some ways are better for players. So what can you do? Our primary advice is to break up your large pack files into smaller ones. Anywhere from 1 megabyte to 4 gigabytes max is totally okay. We've seen some 80 gigabyte pack files, and that's what we want to avoid. The other end is bad too. 100,000 small files leads to bad install time performance. It's also important that changes are localized within a pack file. One change to source content should optimally result in one change to the pack file. Due to the sliding window, adding in content even to the beginning of the file or changing something in the middle is actually totally fine. But if a change to source content causes changes throughout the pack, that's much less good. A really bad example could be if you use absolute offsets to reference between pieces of content. Then one change early in the file would cause very few chunks to be reusable. Another piece of advice is that if you're making archives of loose files, for example, by zipping them up, do this without compression. If you compress, then even small changes early can affect bytes later on. We already compress and encrypt for transfer, so unnecessary compression doesn't save download time. Lastly, the Steamwork docs have tips specifically related to Unreal and Unity, so please reference those if you're using one of those engines. Splitting your game into depots can have a huge impact. Use Depots to split your content up by language or platform. Managing files within Depots, being smart about pack file sizes, and minimizing unnecessary changes will help keep patch sizes reasonable and will result in a better user experience when rolling out updates. It's not just about powerful desktops and fast internet. With portable PCs like Steam Deck and opportunities in emerging markets with slower connections, optimizing for smaller installs and efficient patching is more important than ever. Mastering these systems ensures faster updates, letting your players jump right into your game.